Hi everyone, welcome to this video on creating a React app and adding the React Query Builder component. The Syncfusion Query Builder is a rich and responsive UI for filtering large amounts of data by creating or editing conditions that can be combined with data visualization controls like data grid and charts to view the filtered data. In this video, you will see how to add the Query Builder component in a React application. I will also explain how to add a rule on initial loading and how to integrate and filter grid records. Before proceeding, ensure you have installed the latest versions of Node.js and React. I'll be using Visual Studio Code as my editor and showing the output in the Chrome browser. First, I'll open Visual Studio Code, create a new application using the npx create React app command, and name it My React App. Since I want to create the app with TypeScript, I add the template TypeScript. It will take a few seconds to create the project. Next, I navigate to the newly created React app. To use the Query Builder component, I type the npm install at syncfusion/ej2-react-query-builder --save command. Now, the package will be installed. Before using a Syncfusion component, I must register the trial license key. I open the index.tsx file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. To generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description below. From the 2022 Volume 1 release, the Syncfusion React license key registration is mandatory. Next, I open the app.tsx file and remove the default code snippets and import the Query Builder component from the Syncfusion EJ2 React Query Builder package. Then, I add the Query Builder component tag. Next, I define the columns to be displayed in the Query Builder. You can create or delete a condition or group based on columns. I set the columns property to column data. Assign the column data object with field, label, and type with appropriate values. After that, I will define the CSS styles for the Query Builder component. I open the app CSS file and import the material theme CSS references. I have also added dependent CSS references like buttons, pop-ups, and lists. Next, save the changes and run the application using the npm start command. See, a basic Query Builder is rendered. It allows you to create conditions and group them using and/or logic. Notice the columns are shown in the dropdown, and you can add conditions based on them. Next, let me show you how to set rules for the component's initial rendering. I set the rule property to import rule. Then I define the import rule object. And inside this function, specify the condition as or, the rules as label to title, field to title, type to string, operator to ends with, and value to representative. Check now, the specified rule is applied to the Query Builder on initial loading. Next, I will show you how to integrate the Query Builder with the grid component. In this example, I am going to filter the grid records using the Query Builder. First, to render the grid component, I install the grid package using the npm install at syncfusion/ej2-react-grids --save command. Next, I import the grid component from the Syncfusion EJ2 React Grids package and add the grid component tag. Then, I add the existing React data grid code snippet here. The explanation for this code snippet is given clearly in the React Grid documentation page, which can be found in the description below. Also, check out the video link in the card above to learn more about the React Grid component. To filter the grid records on changing the rules, I use the RuleChange event. I assign the callback method, updateRule, to this RuleChange event and define it here, and it receives arguments of type RuleChangeEventArgs. Notice that this interface is imported from the Syncfusion EJ2 React Query Builder. I import the query and predicate modules from the EJ2 data package. To get the Query Builder rule, I create the Query Builder instance and refer that in the Query Builder component tag. And to update the filtered data source to the grid, I create the grid instance and refer that in the grid component tag. To filter records based on the rules, I declare a variable predicate and get the rule by calling a rule method using a Query Builder instance. I add an if condition to check whether the predicate is undefined or null, and then construct a query to update all the records. Otherwise, I will build the query to upload the records based on the predicate. Finally, refresh the grid component using the refresh method. Notice here, the grid component is rendered. When I apply the rule, records will be updated. To apply the rule on initial loading, I add the created event and assign the callback method on grid created. Then, define this method. Inside this method, call the updateRule method and pass the rule to the getValidRules method using the Query Builder object. As its name indicates, it converts the rule into a valid one. Check now, the grid records are filtered based on the rule applied on the Query Builder's initial rendering. In this video, I have shown you how to add the Query Builder component to a React application. I also showed you how to apply rules on initial loading and filter grid records. If you want to try out the example used in this video, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also shared a link to learn about obtaining a free license key to use our React suite through our community license if you are eligible. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it helpful, please like and subscribe to our channel.